The Uganda National Examinations Board, UNEP, has officially released a timetable for the 2024 national examinations, marking the introduction of the first cohort of candidates for the new lower secondary curriculum, NLSC. The UCE examinations for the new curriculum are expected to commence on the 11th October and will run till 8th November. Those retaking examinations under the old curriculum will start on the 11th of October and end on 15th November. PLE will begin on 4th November and end on 7th November. USCE will begin on 8th November till 6th December.
My pleasure to release to the public the timetables for the 2024 examinations.
Dan Odon, the executive director for UNEP, elaborated on this year's examinations theme and how it relates to the new curriculum.
This year's theme is embracing security and holistic assessment of learners in a dynamic environment. That is, embracing security and holistic assessment of learners in a dynamic environment.
Odon, however, warned that candidates whose continuous assessment and project scores are not submitted to UNEP will not be graded.
In that connection, the board has trained 15 teachers in each school throughout the country so that they are able to compute and submit these assessment scores without a problem. I like to sound this warning that without the coursework and the project scores, the candidates will not be graded. Any candidate who does not submit, for whom no coursework is submitted, or for whom no project score is submitted, will not be graded.
A total of 1,320,400 candidates are set to sit the 2024 exams, marking a 7.8% increase compared to 2024. Residents of Kichwamba and Katerera sub-counties in Bushenyi district have expressed concerns about the government's delay in compensating individuals affected by wildlife damage. Despite Parliament passing a proposal for wildlife compensation, residents claim that the Uganda Wildlife Authority, UWA, has been slow in paying those who suffered injuries as well as whose gardens suffered wildlife damage. Robert Chumwine, a resident of Mbara, is a victim who was promised compensation by UWA after a buffalo attacked his father and killed him. He said despite providing all the necessary documentation asked by UWA, he has not received the promised compensation.
My dad was digging somewhere in his garden, outside the game park, and that animal killed him last year. Then I reported to UWA, and they come on that day burial. Then they promised us to give us a compensation.
Local leaders say that some community members pay a heavy price by keeping watch over their crops through the night against wildlife that infiltrates their communities from Lake Mburo National Park.
Konga mbichiriza tuzichumite kandi mwaza kuzihiga zom park ekiragiro nkigira kuzikuzom park kuzikurata so ziguma hihari.
The park chief warden, Pontius Ezuma, acknowledges that there is a need to amend the law in regard to compensations. He also noted that there are some locals who have encroached on wildlife reserves and are therefore not eligible for compensation if they are attacked.
There are only 5 animals to be compensated. That is the elephant,
The Committee on Tourism, Trade and Industry, led by the chairperson Sylvia Nayebare, visited the communities to investigate the issues of compensation for the wildlife victims by UWA. In the findings, legislators noted that the challenges are many and they wish to invite UWA officials to appear before the committee to find solutions.
Ebumwatereza byona nibaza kubahandika bavandikire ebumwatereza okwe murugunya kwanyu haza Kampala tube nibo twabhereze vuzo binji no kukira.
The SpaceX crew that will ferry back in February two astronauts stranded on the International Space Station docked with the orbiting laboratory on Sunday. A live streaming of the mission showed NASA astronaut Nick Hague and Russian cosmonaut Alexander Gobunov boarded the ISS and embraced their floating colleagues. The Falcon 9 rocket took off at 1:17 p.m. 17:17 GMT from Cape Canaveral, Florida on Saturday with the Crew 9 mission aboard. A Dragon spacecraft contacting the ISS at 5:30 p.m. yesterday. After docking was completed, NASA astronaut Nick and Russian cosmonaut Alexander boarded the station just after 7 p.m., embracing the floating colleagues.
The bell has been rung. Alexander Gobunov, the first through of Crew 9, being welcomed by Expedition 72. Next up is Crew 9 Commander Nick Hague.